The world is changing, sometimes not as quickly as we'd like. But EVs or electric vehicles are now a reality and they're here for good. Sure, we have a few offerings at best, but that will change. The Hyundai Kona Electric's arrival in July last year set the ball rolling. While it was not India's first EV, it certainly was one of the most plush, practical, credible mass brand offerings in the EV space. And then earlier this year, the MG ZS EV got here too. Now, while they're not exactly alike, they do make for a spicy face-off. First, let's focus on the looks, shall we? The Kona Electric first. I've liked the Kona for some time now, mainly for its compact footprint. That applies to the ICE and electric versions since they have the same body dimensions and shape. So the Kona is well proportioned, well built, and really fits the urban requirements perfectly. And yes, that's also what a lot of buyers are looking for these days. And then throw in its modern looks. Well, that will attract a lot of people too. The face with its slim lights up top treatment is in keeping with Hyundai's new SUV design language. Well, it gets accentuated on the EV, and so we don't have the regular one, we only get the EV. So look at that, there is no front grille. And so when you see one of these coming from a great distance, you straight away know what car this is. And that perhaps is the whole point. Now, I'm not going to tell you which is the better looking car because you've got to decide that. Very subjective. I will that I agree this is a nice modern looking product, but that is exactly why its looks are very polarizing. So some people will find that extremely appealing. They'll also like the fact that it wears its EV tag, well, not on its sleeve, but on its face. In this case, you get a car that's more conventional looking. It looks bigger. It looks more SUV proportioned, especially when you put them together. So to a lot of people who don't necessarily want to announce the fact that they have an EV or just like the way a regular car looks, this is going to work better. So it may be the safer design, but I do think that it's therefore the more appealing one. On the inside, the Kona looks better built and comes across as more premium, but the cabin is definitely small, possibly not much bigger than on a premium hatchback. The plastics feel good, but the palette is a bit dull. The 7-inch touchscreen is the central piece to the dash layout and offers Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, navigation, and more. Then there are the ventilated seats, the wireless phone charging and driver-only air conditioning option, which keeps the throw of cold air limited to the driver's seat when needed, thereby reducing energy consumption. The ZS EV's cabin straight away looks roomier, but would have looked even bigger had it got lighter tones instead of all black. There are two variants and the top spec matches, in fact, outdoes the Kona on features. An 8-inch touchscreen with Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, navigation, and also the inbuilt eSIM connected iSmart features like on the Hector. There's also a panoramic sunroof, a PM2.5 air filter, and more. Both cars get 6 airbags, electronic stability control or ESC, and anti-lock brakes or ABS, as standard. Isofix child seat mounts are also standard, so both do well on safety. And each claims high levels of crash safety, but we do not have crash test results for an Indian-built one. Both cars are assembled in India. Three different drive modes and also three levels of regenerative braking. In fact, you put it into the third one,
using the paddle shifts, and you can almost go single pedal, which is kind of fun. But that's a lot like many other EVs, so I won't go on about that. It is the overall drive, performance and feel of the car that is its USP when you're on the road. And by that, I am indicating its sporty handling. It does a good job of cornering, and again, it kind of throws you because you don't expect an EV typically to do that. But that's how good the EVs are getting these days. Now, it's the steering that's a little bit too soft for my liking. But for the most part, buyers or even users who have tried out the Kona EV, I found it very comfortable, very easy to drive, very easy to get used to.
Yes, the car drives well, and the experience was very similar to the time I spent with the Kona Electric in Korea last year too. The car is a credible electric vehicle because it doesn't just focus on being green, but instead also offers driving pleasure. The claimed range is 452 kilometers, though in the real world, expect 360 or so.
Now, the Kona is definitely the sportier of the two, and so a little bit more driver-oriented. It's the comfort on this car that will grab you, though. It's the right quality, it is surprising, and it's very supple. You still sit sort of tall from an SUV perspective, but especially for Indian road conditions, you'll find the right quality really works well. It's also very different to the Hector, I can tell you. And it is going to be the one big USP, because a lot of people, in terms of their usage, you know, there'll be family usage, they might even have a chauffeur driving them. Yeah, they'll find this more comfortable.
The roomier backseat will help that cause. The ZS EV's driving range is 340 kilometers, and MG says that the real-world figures will still stay above 300. The car is easy to drive, its steering is also fairly responsive, and it will surprise you in many ways with its road manners, which far outshine its sibling, the Hector. Both cars have the 50-minute fast charging option as well as the conventional slow charger that uses a regular plug. Hyundai and MG have each invested in some partnerships to provide charging points around the country, and especially in the cities where these cars are on sale. So MG matches Hyundai's plan to have not just an outsourced network, fast chargers at its dealerships, and the home charging installation, but it does one better, where in an emergency, you can also call for roadside assistance to give you a boost charge, allowing you to get to your destination or nearest charging point. So MG has this better covered and intends to grow this out further since it has more EVs coming. A quick look at the prices, and yes, both have tried to be as aggressive as was possible given our customs duties, and you'd have to think that MG tried a little bit harder here. So the verdict then, which one should you buy?
I have been impressed with the Kona right from the first time I ever drove one, because it's a well-conceived and then well-executed product. It was done for the right reasons, and that is why it's been such a big success. And it also hits on the SUV note, which was the reason perhaps for some of its big success, and also its good reception here in India. And you know what, MG just kind of takes that to the next level by going even more obviously SUV with the ZS. That's not a bad thing either. So which car wins, you might ask? And you know what, I know a lot of people are going to say I am comparing apples with oranges, because they're not really exactly the same kind of product. It's true, but to the buyer, this is pretty much what you're going to get to choose from. And so in that sense, I have to say that I will go with the ZS. Why? It's the bigger car. It's also the more obviously SUV looking car, and that's something that the buyer will certainly pick up on in terms of real world driving range, and also the internet inside tag, panoramic sunroof if you want to add that. Yes, It just does a lot more. But then, you know what? We'd hopefully have a situation where we just have a lot more options in the EV space, and hopefully that happens soon. We could have different body styles, we could have different sizes, different driving ranges, different price points as well. But while I'm talking about an ideal world, then you know what? In an ideal world, that's the kind of urban EV I would like to drive, because it would give you snob value, it would give you the green tag, and it would also give you extremely sporty driving with a nice small urban footprint. There is a reason why the i3 won World Urban Car of the Year, and before that even the World Green Car of the Year. But all of this is academic, because of course this car has not launched and is not launching in the Indian market anytime soon.